According to Luca Buscan, the executive director, Buckley Energy, and the project developer, work on the project started in 2005 but did not progress steadily until 2017, when a bilateral agreement was finalized between the two countries. He said the project is expected to produce approximately 130 GWL per year at over 92% plant load factor. This may present the highest utilization factor of any hydro project in Uganda. The project will provide supply and stability to the power grids in southwestern Uganda and northwest Tanzania.
This will be perhaps the project with the highest utilization factor of any in Uganda. This is due to the exceptional nature of this hydro resource, and it will make this project very important to supply stable power into the power grids in southwest Uganda and northwest Tanzania.
This is a cross-border project that fits the East African Community Vision 2050 and Article 101 of the Treaty for the Establishment of the East African Community, under which the partner states agreed, among others, to cooperate in the exploitation of renewable energy resources to supply affordable energy to their people. In his speech, President Yoweri Museveni hailed the project, saying Tanzania and Uganda governments have begun to utilize the potential of Kagera River. Museveni thanked the late President Magufuli and the current President Samia Suluhu for supporting the project.
When we build dams with the Chinese, like the Karoma you are hearing about, the production cost is 4.8 cents. Karuma, the one the minister was talking about, 4.8 cents, Isimba, 4.8 cents. Now, our partners, the Germans and our other friends, how can we make this electricity cheaper? What witchcraft can we use?
The president of Tanzania, Samia Suluhu Hassan, applauded the vision of President Yoweri Museveni in originating the project. She said the project will foster macroeconomic outcomes.
And so this project is going to immensely contribute to that effect. While our countries continue to record an impressive economic growth, our responsibility as heads of states and government is to direct the investment to such these areas, like here where we are, whereby the investment shall catalyze the macroeconomic development of the area.
Meanwhile, the two presidents also launched the beginning of the long-term integration of the Uganda and Tanzania national ICT backbone infrastructure. According to the ICT Minister, Dr. Chris Bariomosi, the project will boost telecom companies in the two countries.
Your Excellency, following your directive, we have since, through NITAU, had engagements with our counterparts in Tanzania, particularly the NITAU team, which is here with me, has had engagements with Tanzania Telecommunications Company Limited and agreed on a memorandum of understanding to be signed by both countries in a bid to ensure affordability and reliability.
Report compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.